I call myself a democratic socialist.
No, you're not. You're a social democrat. Hey, it's Zlat, and this is Democratic Socialism versus Social Democracy. I come across this very often, and I feel like there's general confusion between these two ideologies. On one side, we often have social democrats calling themselves democratic socialists, and on the other side, we have some right-wingers calling liberals and social democrats socialists and communists. And this culminates in massive confusion and pointless arguments, and it doesn't have to be this way. Let's start with talking about what these ideologies have in common. First, they would be both considered leftist. And to extremely oversimplify, we would generally define leftist ideologies as those who prefer economic collectivism over individualism. Although, depending on the status quo in your country, social democracy could be considered center-left or centrist. Next, history. Both democratic socialism and social democracy originally stem from Marxism, and for much of the early 20th century, the lines between social democrats and democratic socialists have been blurred. A few examples might include the Mensheviks in Russia or the Labour Party in the UK, which has evolved, along with the labour movement worldwide, from a democratic socialist to a social democratic party. Additionally, both ideologies are inherently electoralist, and both wish to establish their end goal via democratic means and the framework that democracy provides. And this is where we see the main difference, the overall end goal of the ideology. The end goal of social democrats is still within a capitalist system. However, the system has to have a framework of social nets, public education, public healthcare, and even some public businesses. Even though the state is greatly expanded, they do not seek to abolish the capitalist system. They just seek to change it. On the other hand, the end goal of democratic socialists is to abolish the whole capitalist system and continue in a socialist economy, be it a market socialist economy or a planned economy. Basically, we can say that democratic socialists are radical social democrats, and while they would agree on many issues, their respective ideal societies are very different. The right-wing equivalent of this might be anarcho-capitalists and libertarians, with ANCAPs wanting to abolish the system altogether and libertarians just wanting to reform it. Now that we know all the definitions, let's talk about where I see the main problem with this misunderstanding. The policies that American left-wing politicians like Bernie Sanders, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, or Elizabeth Warren propose are not democratic socialist. Sure, a democratic socialist would definitely agree with them, but the ideas themselves are social democratic. Not to mention that all of the countries, such as Sweden or Norway, they are inspired by are not socialist. They just have a history of social democracy. And this is when we come to the Overton window. Very quickly explained, the Overton window describes what is acceptable in political discourse and what is not. And while social democracy is very much acceptable all over Europe and South America, democratic socialism would be very niche and inspire fear in many potential voters. And the only one who benefits from blurring of the line between democratic socialism and social democracy are far-left radicals who slowly peer into the Overton window. To add a little footnote at the end, even as someone generally libertarian-leaning, I honestly believe that a strong social democratic party helps to stop left-wing populism, which, if left unchecked, can be extremely dangerous. I'd say the best example of this is the German Socialdemokratische Partei, whose existence definitely helped in stability after the unification of Germany. In conclusion, Scandinavia is not socialist, don't call yourself a democratic socialist if you're a social democrat, and the US would really benefit from a multi-party system. Thanks a ton for watching this video. I do hope you've enjoyed it, and please share it with people who would benefit from watching this. Bye.